What's up, you guys? My name's Mina. Welcome to my channel, Mina Reads. And today, I just wanted to bring you guys some fantasy recs that I think will be really good for beginners. I know that I am still pretty early in my, you know, fantasy journey. I haven't read some of those bigger names yet, but I wanted to talk to you guys about some of the books that I started on, like, my fantasy journey and why I think that they might be good for some other beginners. That's what this video is all about, and I hope if you guys are interested, you'll keep on watching, and maybe you'll leave me a like and some comments. Also, follow me on Twitter and Instagram if you'd like to see me talk more about these books or other books, or you just want to see more of my lovely face. It would be wonderful if you could subscribe and all that. So yeah, anyways, enough self-promotion. Let's talk about the books. So I think that Kings of the Wild is such a fun fantasy. So in this fantasy world, we have bands, and these bands are mercenary bands. However, these mercenary bands are treated kind of like rock stars will be treated in the modern world. So they're famous and they have songs sung about them. They have fans. They kind of perform in arenas where they kill monsters and stuff like that. And so Clay Cooper is a part of this really famous band, and this band is old, washed up, and retired. And they essentially decide to get the band back together because they need to save one of the band members, Gabriel's daughter. So they decide to get the band back together so that they can save Gabriel's daughter Rose and help this city that's under siege. If you like journey books, you will enjoy this because this story is essentially a journey as they come and like collect all of the various members of the band, and then they, you know, they have to gather up this magical item and that magical item to go fight the big battle. Very fun. It's very satirical. It really doesn't take itself too seriously, and I really, really enjoyed that. I also think that if you're someone who really likes fantasy that has like a lot of fantastical creatures, you know, like giants and like ogres, I think that you might really enjoy this. And I just really loved it. I thought it was really funny. It was really fun to me, and I don't know, it was just super enjoyable. And if you enjoy this one, you might want to read the second book in the series, which is called The Bloody Rose. It follows Gabriel's daughter that I mentioned, but the main character in that, she is a lesbian named Tam, and she's a bard for a famous band. Not this one, but a different one. And the sequel is also really cool, and like, we love the diverse cast in the books. I just really think that it's super good and super fun, and I think that if you want a fantasy that's not too serious, and it's not like, because some fantasy can be really, you know, it can be really gritty, really intense, and it can feel like really heavy. And I feel like that's something that was a concern for me as a fantasy beginner. It's like, I don't want to read super heavy fantasy all the time. So I thought that this was a really perfect entryway for me because it was fun and it was funny, but it also had like an emotional heart. I was really connected to it. I think if you like the found family dynamics, you will enjoy this. And I really like it. I would definitely only recommend it if you enjoy journey books. If you don't like journey books, you may not have the best time with this one. So the next book that I have to recommend to you guys is The Poppy War by R.F. Kuang. This book, we follow a character named Rin. She is an orphan and she lives with her adoptive parents, but they treat her like trash. They're planning to marry her off to this older, gross man, and she decides that that's absolutely not the life that she wants for herself. So she decides to study for this really prestigious and incredibly hard exam called the Keju, and if she is able to pass, she will be able to attend a military academy called Sinigard. And we follow Rin as she undertakes this incredible task of trying to study for the Keju as an uneducated peasant, and she gets into Sinigard, and we basically follow her journey from this military academy into an actual war as war breaks out in this empire of Nicara. And this book is so good. When Rin goes to Sinigard, she becomes a shaman, which is a person who basically takes drugs so they can commune with the gods, and she becomes like an emissary almost for this phoenix goddess. And it's just like, Rin is such an icon. The magic system in this is really interesting, and the way that the shamans like operate in this society, and just like the fantasy, the world building, the politics of it all is really intriguing. I think Rin is an amazing character, and I think that this is just such a fantastic book. I think that this will be a really good book for you as a newbie to fantasy if you like stories that are, I don't want to say character driven in a way to detract from like the plot, because there is a lot of plot elements, there's a lot of action, there's a lot of fighting, but I think that if you're like a character person and you need to feel a connection to the character to care about the story, I feel like you will connect to Rin as a character, because Rin is so determined, felt so immediately connected to her because she was so passionate and so dedicated to her goals. this book will just be so good because Rin is an amazing character. I think that it makes some really amazing critiques about war and imperialism, and I just think that is super duper great in almost all ways. But I would only recommend this if you're someone who feels like you will be able to handle a military fantasy. This book is very heavy. So the next book is not going to be a surprise to anyone who's been on my channel for any amount of time, but it is The City of Brass by S.A. Chakraborty. In The City of Brass, we follow a character named Nahri. Nahri is a con woman, and she essentially cons people by, you know, making people think that she has magical powers and the ability to heal people. So on one such occasion, she's conning these people and she's singing a song meant to heal a sick girl. And in singing this song, she essentially awakens this djinn and calls him to her. And in meeting this djinn named Dara, he takes her to the magical djinn city of Devabad, where she discovers that, you know, she is a part of this powerful and prestigious djinn family. I think that you will enjoy this if you like journey books, if you like interesting magical creatures. I think you will enjoy this if you like really political fantasy, because this is very political and the politics of the city of Devabad is really what drives this story forward. The politics and the political strife within Devabad, as there are multiple Deva tribes that really do not like each other. The story is really driven by political conflict between these like warring tribes and groups within Devabad. I think that you will enjoy this if you like really lush prose, really vivid fantasy, and the characters. These characters are so interesting, so dynamic, and I think that the relationships that they have with each other, the interactions that they have, are all really interesting, and I highly, highly recommend this series. So then we have Jade City, which is another book that I think that if you've been on my channel for any amount of time, you will know that I absolutely adore this book, but I want to talk to you guys a little bit more about why I think that it would be really good for a beginner to fantasy. We follow this family called the Calls, and the Calls live in a city called Janlun in a country called Kaikon, and the Calls are essentially a mafia family, and they are a Greenbone clan, and Greenbone clans essentially have the power to wield this bioenergetic jade that is native to their country of Kaikon, and in wielding this bioenergetic jade, so it gives them superhuman abilities. And this book is about two warring Greenbone clans, the Calls and the Ait family, and how they are warring over their country's jade supply. Now, this is a really, really cool, really interesting fantasy. I absolutely love it for a million reasons, but I'm going to tell you why I think that this is really good for a beginner to fantasy. I think that this is good for a beginner to fantasy for multiple reasons. One reason being that it does have multiple POVs. A lot of fantasies have multiple POVs, and I think that this is a really good entryway into multiple POV fantasy, because some fantasy, say for example Game of Thrones, where there's a lot of point of views in Game of Thrones, and all the characters in Game of Thrones are dealing with wildly different circumstances. They're in wildly different places when all of their concerns are super duper different. So if you like one person's point of view and one person's storyline more than the other, then it might make the other point of view chapters be a bit slow for you. However, I think that Jade City does it well, where we have all these different point of views, but they're all in the same location, dealing with the same issues, but on different levels, as we have some people who are at the top of the clan, like Lan, who is the pillar of their clan, and then we have their cousin Anden, who is just a teenage student trying to live his life in the middle of a mafia war. So I think that it shows you the conflicts of the story from multiple different point of views in an interesting way without, you know, confusing you as a reader with too much information and too many storylines or locations at once. So that's why I think it would be good for an entry to multiple point of view fantasy. I also think it'd be really good for you if you're just entering fantasy and maybe you're not a huge fan of like medieval settings, because I know that that's something that kind of alienates me from fantasy. I don't necessarily love historical settings. I'm not a fan of like historical European inspired type fantasy. It just does absolutely nothing for me. And this is Asian inspired, particularly inspired by like Hong Kong and like Taiwan, inspirations that the city is based on. So I think that if you want like an interesting fantasy setting, you want something that's more contemporary, more modern, as it is set in kind of like the 1970s. I think it would be good for that. If you need something more contemporary, you need a more unique setting. It's all just really great. Totally recommend it. It's just fantastic. Amazing character dynamics, amazing family dynamics, the war, the politics, the action. Fonda Lee is an icon and a legend, and you should totally read this. And the last book that I have to recommend you guys is Black Sun by Rebecca Roanhorse. Now, this is a really new release, and I absolutely adored it. I read it just last week, and it, like, I feel like my life was changed by it, low key, which is so dramatic to say, but I absolutely adored this book. So This book is set in pre-Columbian Americas, so it's set in, like, you know, indigenous civilizations prior to Columbus coming and colonizing the Americas. So we have multiple POVs. We have Shala, who is a bisexual sea captain slash mermaid, and she has been tasked with taking this young man named Serapio to this city called Tova. And Serapio, he is basically the prophesied, like, second coming of this crow god, and he has this immense power, and essentially he needs to get to this city called Tova on the day of the solar eclipse for him to fulfill this prophecy. So there's this air of destiny and foreboding around his character, but he's this really sweet and innocent feeling kind of character, and he just wants, like, friendship and connection, but also maybe he's the god come to destroy the earth as we know it. And the journey that him and Shala take getting to the city of Tova is incredibly interesting. And then we also have a third POV, Naranpa, who is the sun priestess of Tova, and she governs the religion in this area, and she is the highest priestess in the sun priesthood, but there are many people vying for her position, and so there's kind of like political intrigue going on. And I just think that this is going to be a really good book for you if you're new to fantasy, if you're old to fantasy, I don't really care. I think everybody should read it. It's really, really amazing, much more amazing than I'm making it sound. But essentially, I think the reason that it would be good for you as a entryway to fantasy is because the writing is really beautiful, really accessible. It immediately grips you. The first chapter of this is, like, amazing. The pacing of this is wonderful. So if, like, slow-paced fantasy is not for you, I would definitely recommend this. Rebecca Roanhorse has her foot on the gas the entire book, and there is not a single moment of this book that kind of lets up in terms of intrigue or action. So I think that you will, you know, be engaged the entire time. And I also think that the characters, they just feel really interesting, and you just want to know more about them. You want more interactions between them. And I also think that this book is really amazing because this society is not heteronormative. The book acknowledges that there are lots of people in this society who are not cisgender, who are not heterosexual, and I really appreciate that, particularly a main character who's a point of view character, Shala. She is bisexual, and then there also are multiple non-binary characters throughout this, and I just really appreciated that. I think that if you want, you know, a fantasy that is not, you know, completely ignoring the fact that queer people exist, like, we love to see it. I just think that this book was so interesting. It was so unique. It was so fun in a way. It made me feel emotional. I was immediately wrapped up in this story, immediately connected to the characters, and I would just definitely recommend it. So anyway, that's basically what I have for you guys today. And if you have some fantasy recommendations for me, can you please leave them in the comments below? Because like I said, I'm also a beginner on my fantasy journey, so I'd love to know what you guys are reading or what you think is an absolute must read for me as a fantasy beginner. So thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you all in my next video. Bye, you guys. And a special thank you to all of my wonderful patrons.